All right, welcome back. We are at headquarters, but we are in the lounge area in the back. Last time you were with me in the last vlog, we talked about maps and kind of what we were going to do in social studies. You got to learn about maps and the five key elements of a map that gives you all the information the map holds. The title, the key or legend, where they tell you what the symbols mean. The directionality or direction of it to help you orient or get to know which way the map should be facing. You have a scale to let you know how the markings or how a map distance on the map relates to the real world. Remember that we had that 1 inch equals 9 miles. That's just one example. It can be any other example. And then we also had grids, which some maps have and some don't. Grids are just a tool to help you find stuff on the map. All right. This vlog is going to be short. It's more going to be about just explaining what you get to do today. I want you guys, with your best map-making skills, to make a map of where you live. It can be the inside of where you live. It can be the outside of where you live. It can be a park by your house, but I think it'll work better if you have just the inside or your yard, if you have a yard. You're going to make a map of that. You're going to want to include lots of detail in it. You don't want just a big room that says bedroom. No, you're going to want to have where your bed is and where, if you have a desk, your kitchen. You're going to want to let the people know where your refrigerator is or your stove. And you're going to want to have lots of detail in it. You're also going to want to include a few of those key things that a map always has. A title. That could be just where your map is of. You're also going to want to have the key or legend. This is going to be the most important one. So all those little things you draw on the map, if you draw a little picture of a bed, you want to represent it by showing a little picture of in the key area so people know what that is. Or if you're going to draw a refrigerator, draw that. If you're going to draw a dotted line for like a path you always take, you're going to want to write that in the key that says these dotted lines mean a path. The reason you're going to have to do all those things is because after you make your map, you're gonna take a little object from your house. It can be something small, like a matchbox car, or it could be a special little doll you have, or something like that, and you're going to hide it somewhere in your house that your map relates to. So you can't put it outside if you didn't draw an outside map. But if you drew a map of what the inside of your house looks like, hide it somewhere in there, and then you're gonna put an X on that map, and then you're gonna go find someone you live with, give them the map, and see if they can find that object. They're gonna have to use the tools that every map should have. They're gonna have to use the title, they're gonna have to use the key, and they're definitely gonna have to use directions if they're gonna look for your item. After they do all that, have fun seeing if they can try to find it. Be sure, at some point in time, you can do this before they do the treasure map hunting. Be sure that you upload a picture of your map to us so we can see what you guys did for your maps. And make sure to have the title, a key, and all those important pieces for a map. Hopefully this is a fun activity you can do with someone in your house. And I will see you in the next vlog.